What's good, Clutch Team? Today we're going to lay down the most recent starting pitching trade rumors. We will run down the top 10, cannot miss, and sleepers in trade rumors too, starting pitching edition. Number 10, Drew Pomeranz. One of the many successful Billy Beane projects was traded from Oakland early last December for Yonder Alonso. Knowing the A's are a low-budget team, there is no chance they could take on a big contract. Pomeranz averaged a 3.08 ERA in Oakland in his career. Coming into the All-Star break with a 2.47 ERA with San Diego in one season, and over 102 innings pitched, and is on pace to throw 200 innings pitched by the end of the season. Obviously, a team will have to give up a little bit, but not as high demand. Number 9, Anthony DeFonsi. The 6'1", 6th-round pick from New Jersey is quietly impressing. This season was 6 games under his belt, supporting a 2.23 ERA and 36.1 innings pitched. Anthony's contract will run through 2016, which means he will be a free agent by the end of this year. If you ask me if I would take a chance on him, I would say, what chance? There is nothing to risk. What does Cincinnati want? An irrelevant minor leaguer in cash considerations? If it doesn't work out, then there was no consequences to the trade. You know? Number 7, Rich Hill. Surprisingly at 36, this has been his most consistent year of his MLB career, mainly because of injuries. He has been hurt in the past and not been able to be consistent. Hill could be a nice addition to a playoff team. He's a 6'5", 220-pound Oakland Athletic from Boston, has posted a 2.25 ERA, and has won 9 of his 13 games so far. Number 6, Jimmy Nelson. A 6'6", 250-pound anchor was drafted in the second round of the 2010 draft. He has seen nothing but improvements every year. In 2014, he had an ERA nearly at 5. That's terrible. In 2015, we saw a significant drop of his ERA, all the way down to 4.11. Halfway through the season so far this year, he is at 3.62 and is on pace for 200 innings. I believe the best days for Jimmy Nelson are ahead of him. All right, now we're on number 5, Josh Tomlin. With the Cleveland Indians rotation, Tomlin is the fifth man in the rotation. His numbers have gone up a little bit from last year, but still holds a 3.51 ERA and 100 innings pitched so far this year, which could be traded to a team that needs him more than the Indians. Number 4, CC Sabathia. The longtime Yankee, former Cy Young Award winner, multiple All-Star game appearances, has fallen on hard times due to high velocity drop. In the past 3 or 4 seasons, unlike Jared Weaver, CC has managed to keep his team in games this year by keeping his ERA under 4, with the Yankees falling apart this year. It would be logical to trade CC. Number 3, Julio Teheran. A young Colombian with diverse speeds on his pitches has gained interest from many teams. Julio has a 2.96 ERA with an unbelievable 118 innings pitched so far this year, and an 8.1 strikeout to per 9 ratio. Even though Atlanta probably won't give up their ace, there will be teams willing to dump their prospects. Number 2, Chris Archer. After finishing second last year in the Cy Young race, the American League with a 3.23 ERA, which is crazy what he's done this year. It's weird how it happened. And he had a crazy 10.7 strikeout per 9 ratio, 212 innings pitched last year. Archer probably is the most shocking player this year, with his numbers just skyrocketing up to 4.66 ERA. He's 4-12 record, which, you know, run support has to play key in that. He is on pace to finish with 224 innings pitched, which is a bright side, by the end of this season. His stock has fallen, so that's good for teams to try to attack and try to regain his Cy Young ability. Number 1, Sonny Gray. The Oakland A, Sonny Gray, is having the worst year of his career, from going with last year a 2.73 ERA up to a 5.0 is a shocker, but for good reason. Sonny has dealt with arm issues in the past. There's a beautiful thing about the trading for Sonny Gray. He is signed to a team-friendly contract, which could draw interest from the whole league. Sonny Gray will return to Cy Young form. Trust me, you should trade for him. Alright, guys. That was my top 10 starting pitching trade rumors. I want y'all to put y'all's list under the comments. That's what I want y'all to do. And I want to do a top 10 hitting, top 10 trade rumors for batters here soon in a little bit. Just letting y'all know. I'm probably going to stream MLB tonight, maybe UFC or anything. I'm not quite sure yet. But guys, love y'all. Appreciate the support for that guy who sent the comment saying, I deserve more subscribers. That makes me want to do YouTube more. That's the type of person I want to meet on YouTube. I appreciate it, man.